Well, that guy certainly proved himself to be expendable. You know, like the movie, The Expendables, with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Hi, this is Let's Play Popful Male Redux, and I'd like to introduce you to a few new friends of mine. This guy I like to call Professor Birdman. He will disappear and teleport, and he will shoot bolts of energy at you, but if you stunlock him, he's pretty easy to deal with. There were two of them there. I guess they don't really teleport, they just kind of phase out and phase back in. You have to walk away from them and then walk back to get them to reappear. Man, these platforms are straight out of Sonic 1. There's some weird enemies in this section, and a really weird boss. This guy I like to call Fire Jake. He's like a fire snake from Mario, except kind of goofy. This guy I like to call Lycanthrope Pete. He is a wolfman who will jump at you with his spear if you do not dispatch him quickly enough. Well, hiya, Fire Jake. What's up? Just hanging out up there? I hear ya. Oh, hey, Pete. I just met your brother. Oh, God. I guess you're not too happy about that. Listen, we had a falling out. I hope we can still be friends. Ah, dang it. If you can just attack this guy quickly enough, he'll stunlock and you won't have to worry about him disappearing. I'm usually not quick enough on the trigger, though. And by the trigger, I mean the A button. Can we jump up there if we're Gaul? Looks... no. Darn, we could have bypassed a little bit of this. But then I wouldn't be able to introduce you to my new friend, Totem Joel. He can help you, but he can also hurt you. Much like many people in real life. Oh God. I was not paying attention to my up aboves. Wow, that one didn't even drop any gold. You know what? I think Gaul is better suited to handle these guys. Ooh, bullion. Like the Birdman, if you can stunlock these guys while they're on the ground, then you don't have to worry about their one attack. Well, their second attack, I guess. Their first attack is just falling down on you from the ceiling. And then if you let them extend, then they fall down a second time and kind of shoot some, I don't know, parts of itself at you. But the radius on that is very small. God, how many of these freaking guys are there? Give me a break. I've had just about enough Totem Joel for one lifetime. Oh, that was interesting. Let's see. Is that this way? No. Actually, you know, I think I want to switch to Male, because we're going to need her in a minute, and we haven't heard much from her lately, so see if she has anything to say. Oh, actually, switch back real quick and heal up my guys. My dude bros. I don't think I need anything. An amulet might be helpful, but I can probably get by without it at this point. And I still have plenty of apples, too. Heal a little bit of damage that Gaul took from the lava. Actually, I can go ahead and sell my bullion. I have 8 apples, 6 bananas. And let's hold on to my money. I still need to buy better equipment for, well, let's see. Oops. I have all the best stuff available for Gaul, but I think I need new armor for Mail. Yeah, new armor and a new accessory. And what do I have for Tat right now? Just the accessory. I still need his armor. Yeah, I better save my money. We probably have some new equipment coming up pretty soon, so I want to have as much money as possible for when I get to that point.
Whoa! What in the world was that? Ta-da! Slicky to the rescue! Guess you just can't finish your job without me, eh, Maley?
Slick? You're still alive?
Well, geez, you don't gotta sound overjoyed or anything. You'd think I'd at least get a big wet kiss or something. But knowing you, I guess it's not in the cards, eh, Maley?
You got that right, loser.
Oh, well, we're still pals, so I'll help you out of this mess. Stand back. This could get messy.
Oh, no, not another bomb!
Woohoo! Woohoo!
He's having a little too much fun.
Ah, the kid's turned into a raving lunatic. Knock it off, Slick. Looks like we've got company.
Sorry, Maley. I got a little carried away once those bombs started popping. What is this?
What else? You did another stupid thing, and now we're in big trouble. The seal! I came here to look for the seal! Understand?
Stand back, Mail. I'll protect you. All right, guys. You know the routine. Hands against the wall and spread them.
Shut up, Slick.
I'm the chief dwarf here. What do you want to know?
Well, you can start by telling me what these massive metal alien thingies are made of. Then I'd like to know where you managed to find your clothes. Is there a short and squatty store around here somewhere? Or do you go in for the tailored thing? Come to think of it, why don't you tell me that first? I'd really like to know.
Will you shut up? Let me handle this. Actually, we were most interested in the Black Seal.
The seal? Oh, ha ha ha! The seal. I made that a long time ago. I was but a boy. It was such a very long time ago.
Okay, Blathers.
Hey! Hello? Hello? Oh, brother. Are you awake?
Oh, I'm so totally unconscious.
Awake. I was, lost in deep thought. I do that sometimes. Now then, you want to know about the seal?
Slick, what do you think you're doing?
It's Mithril! Did you hear me? Mithril, I say! We're gonna be rich! Robin Leach will be banging down my door! I can't wait!
Good. Maybe that'll keep him out of my hair.
Well... Yes, now then... Follow me.
Well, he doesn't seem too worked up about
anything. That's right. Now up this way.
That's easy for you to say. How am I supposed to get up there? I don't use magic.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. It's actually quite safe. Just imagine there are stairs.
Cool. It's an invisible stairway.
Ah, it will always be here, as long as you believe. Behold, the Great Wall of Shikra stands before you. Yes. Let me interpret. Here is an age-old depiction of heaven. You can see those who rebelled against goodness and light. These evil ones would stop at nothing to destroy all that is good. But they were stopped, for the defenders of heaven were legion. This wall is a pictorial account of that battle. It ends at the point where I created the seal. It was a dark time, and many souls were lost. In fact, one still remains in this very place. His name is Sven. Sven T. Uncommon. Once, he fought for good. Now, he fights for the Overlord.
Well, actually, I've already taken care of that pompous jerk.
You mean to say that you defeated Sven?
Yeah, it was pretty easy,
too. That muscle-bound dweeb was all talk. He's history now.
Ah, you see, Sven is like a shadow. When at last you think he is gone, he will once again reappear.
Thank you for leading me right to the old man, Bulimia Blaine.
Sven, how did you...
Oh, Mumbles, have I scared the tired and flabby old dwarf man?
Heretic, do not waggle your blasphemous tongue. You have defiled this temple with your presence.
Sven, you chrome-plated creep! You tricked me into leading you here!
You are so smart that you almost make me want to be afraid, spindly limbs! The old man knows too much about our secret plans. I have wanted to crush his feeble head for so long, but his seal was in my way. Now that you have so kindly let me in, my fantasy is about to come true.
Snake! Coward!
Oh, sticks and stones may break my bones, but you will never have the chance. So long, little small fry.
Wait! Mumbles! This is just great. I finally catch up to him and he gets kidnapped. Oh, if he gets killed, I'll never learn the secret of the seal.
Okay. That was quite a lot of talking. And quite a lot of dramatic events. Yeah, let's go take care of this asshole once and for all. I'm gonna go on ahead and save because I don't know when I'll have another chance. Pretty sure I can save. Yeah, okay, we have a little bit to go. These things are also Sonic-like platforms, and they will shoot spikes up at you if you stand on them too long. I want to switch to Gaul because he's the best at jumping. He's kind of like the Princess Toadstool of this game, or Princess Peach, as I guess she's known now, from Super Mario Bros. 2. She has kind of the floaty jump that's very helpful. Switch back to Mail. I think we have a boss coming up, and we'll want her at the ready.
Listen to me now and believe me later. I did not think you were so tiny brain that you would try to follow me. It's time to teach you a lesson in pounding Papa Toad. Welcome to your nightmare.
All brawn and no brain. Your words don't scare me. I'll finish you this time.
Oh my, what a happy little party. My invitation must have been lost in the mail. But no matter, now that I'm here, Master Sven, may I have the honor of finishing off this little annoyance?
Venuncio, you should feel ashamed to be in the same room with this trash. Shame on you.
Aw, you're not really in a position to be scolding anyone, now are you? Master Sven has promised to reward me well for my total loyalty, and I intend to give it to him.
Oh, when he gets so mushy, it makes my biceps quiver with total joy. But now I have no use for him. It's so sad. I would cry, but then I would have to eat quiche.
What? Wow.
Master Sven! What are you doing? This is a total betrayal!
I prefer to call it spring cleaning. Did you really think that I would team up with your puny baby army? Goodbye, my broken pet.
Mithril Guardian, hear my plea! Help me with your awesome power!
Venuncio, just tell me why!
The magic must be gone now. Oh, I just wanted to create a utopian society, but I needed their power to make it happen. Now I see that good can never come from evil, nor right from wrong. I must pay the ultimate price for my foolishness.
Jump, Venuncio! Hurry!
Goodbye, warrior. Maybe your way is the answer. Never give up!
I mean, he probably could have made that jump. The fire doesn't do that much damage to you. He could have made it over here. Oh well, no matter. Can I save now? Yeah, but it probably... I probably still have to repeat that cutscene. If I do die. But this fight's not too bad. Actually, I can probably save it here. Yeah, that's good. I didn't realize there was going to be a screen transition there.
I'm in the mood to show off my totally toned biceps, bud. Prepare for a pounding.
Don't be so sure of that simple kiddie plan. The last time we fought was only playtime for my perfect pompitude. This time it's for real.
Wow. I wasn't expecting whatever that thing is. So yeah, this fight is pretty simple. It's a little time consuming. All you have to do is stand here. And when he throws his sword, just shoot your boomerang, and that's it. Well, you don't stand here. You have to duck here so your shield blocks the projectiles. Unfortunately, that's the only chance you have to hit this guy, because otherwise his sword will block any shot. So yeah, this is going to be a battle of attrition. We just kind of have to wear him down. Hopefully, the length of this episode makes up for the previous one. Like I said, I prefer having these, I like every video to be a milestone of some sort. Unless the video is just going on way too long. Which this one's almost headed that way, but this will be over pretty soon. You know, I have to say, I've been enjoying doing an LP again instead of just doing streams like I have been. I like streaming too still, but I don't know, going back to LP, it just has it's more relaxing in a way. Like, I don't have to worry about being on all the time. If the video's bad, I can always just stop the video, load my save, and just redo everything. I don't have to I don't have to always come up with something to say, like just now. I don't know, it's kind of liberating in a way. I think even after I'm done doing the donation games, I might keep LPing in addition to streaming. Because I went back over my list of games that I've actually finished, either on stream or in an LP. And for as long as I've been doing this, it's pretty pathetic. I'd like to change that. Actually finish more games. Like the old days, not like the stream where I just play The Binding of Isaac dozens of times. I don't know why this part isn't voiced. I haven't done this in a while, but I'm going to do this to the best of my ability. You are a weak and tiresome little pile of clingy jakes, you lucky baby foes. but you'll need all the luck you can spit up because the real fun begins at Fort Fright. And don't be late, Tiny Brain. I'm sure Mumbles won't want to die alone in his baby poop. Ha 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 ha. Wow. Those are some really great last words. That's going to look good on your tombstone, dude. I don't know. That might not be the last we've seen of him. I guess we'll have to wait and find out. This has been Let's Play Popful Male Redux. Thanks for watching. I hope it's been enjoyable. And you can find a new episode, same channel, on Friday. So I will see you then.